Hello everyone. Today I am going to give a 101 on payment card pins. In this video, we will look at some basic terminologies related to pin, like pin block, clear pin, pin offset, PBV, etc. We will also look at how is pin transmitted between various parties in the payment ecosystem. We will also cover how pin is generated in the issuer ecosystem, like natural pin, customer select pin, etc. We will also look at how PIN gets validated. The first section, let us look at some basic terminologies. Firstly, as we all know, PIN number is a numeric value that is assigned to every card to be used in the transactions. There are three types of PINs. First one is an assigned PIN. It is a PIN number assigned by the issuer based on certain calculation on the PAN number and the PIN key. A random PIN, the second type, is random as it states. It is not based on PAN number or etc. It is just a random number that is generated. The third type is a customer select PIN. This is a PIN number that is selected by the customer. An interesting fact is that as per the ISO standards, the PIN number can range between 4 to 12 digits. However, the recommended and normally used PIN length is 4 to 6 digits. Now, let's look at some terminologies. First one is a clear PIN. A clear PIN is nothing but the actual PIN number itself. However, this clear PIN is not stored or transmitted as is anywhere. Next is PIN block. PIN block is an encrypted PIN number. This PIN block is the value that will be used for transmission purposes. So, how is it generated? First, the PIN is encrypted using an ISO 9564 protocol and then encrypted using a triple test key. This is how a PIN number, whichever is 4 to 6 digit, is converted into a PIN block. I've just given an example. A PIN number, say 1111, based on certain key, looks like a PIN block with the hexadecimal digits like that. The last two terminologies are PIN offset and PBV. These two are usually used for storing PINs in the cardholder databases. Firstly, PIN offset. PIN offset is a difference between a PIN value selected by the customer against the PIN number that would have been naturally assigned by the issuer. It is nothing but a difference of these PIN numbers. However, it is not as straightforward as I said. It is done using a specific algorithm called as IBM 3624 specification. This PIN offset is subsequently stored in the cardholder database and used for PIN validation during the next transaction. The next one is PBV. It is called PIN verification value. It is very similar to PIN offset. However, the algorithm is a bit different. It is Visa's PIN verification value algorithm. The purpose of both PIN offset and PBV is usually to store these in the cardholder database, which will be subsequently used for PIN validation. Now let's look at how PIN is transmitted between various parties in the ecosystem. This is the normal transaction flow that we all know, starting from the terminal to the issuer. Terminal is where we enter the PIN number. So as I mentioned earlier, the PIN is never transmitted in clear from the terminal till the issuer. So first, the terminal creates the PIN block and then encrypts it using a terminal PIN key. Before I go into the PIN keys, let's first understand a concept called as a zone. Every two adjacent parties where the data gets transmitted is called as a zone. If you see here, the first zone is person acquirer. The second zone is acquirer and scheme. The third zone is the scheme to issuer. Between each zone shares a unique PIN key with which the PIN block is encrypted and transmitted between the parties. So this PIN key is called as zone PIN key. So the zone PIN key is unique and only known to the two parties within the zone. First, the PIN block is encrypted by the terminal using a unique key shared between the terminal and the acquirer. This is called as terminal PIN key. Then the acquirer decrypts the PIN block from the TPK and then encrypts the PIN block with a key that is agreed between acquirer and scheme. This is called as acquirer working key. Scheme receives the encrypted PIN block using the AWK and then translates it into a PIN block that is agreed between scheme and issuer called as IWK. This is how the PIN block gets transmitted from the terminal to the issuer. In this section, let's see how natural PIN and the customer select PIN is generated and validated. First, let's look at natural PIN generation. Every issuer usually maintains a CMS system, a HSM system, that is hardware security module, and a transaction switch. HSM is the device or application which is used to generate cryptographic values. Each HSM has its own functions to generate CVV, verify CVV, validate PIN, generate PIN, etc. Every time a card is issued or generated, the CMS system first calls the HSM with the card number and with the required PIN length. HSM generates the PIN number and sends it to CMS back. It sends this PIN only to print and send it to the customer. It is not usually stored. Now, let's look at how the PIN number gets validated during an authorization. When the authorization is received by the switch receives the PIN block from the screen encrypted in the IWK. So, the switch here triggers a PIN verification request to the HSM using the IWK and the PIN key with which the actual PIN was generated. HSM validates the PIN number, that is the PIN block it received, against the PIN number that should have been entered by the customer. HSM returns the result of the PIN validation and sends it back to the switch. Switch uses this and sends the final response to the scheme. The key thing here is, in case of a natural PIN, the CMS system does not usually store the PIN block or the PIN offset, or neither it is required. The IWK is used only to extract the PIN block, and then the PIN verification key, which is used to generate the PIN, is used by the HSM to validate the PIN block. This is a little bit straightforward. Now, let's look at how does customer select PIN work. There are few methods that usually banks provide to select a PIN, using a web portal or using an ATM, etc. In this video, I'm covering what happens when we set a PIN using an ATM. Once the customer enters the PIN of her or his choice, the PIN traverses from the acquirer switch to the scheme, and finally, the issuer receives the PIN block encrypted using the IWK. Now, the PIN block contains a customer select PIN related PIN block. The switch triggers an API to the HSM with the IWK and the PVK to get the PIN offset or the PVV. It will be either a PIN offset or a PVV, depending on which method the issuer actually uses. HSM returns the offset value. Once the issuer switch gets the offset value, then the switch updates the offset value in the CMS cardholder database. And then the issuer switch returns the response to the ATM. Why do we store the offset value in the CMS system? Is because whenever an authorization is received by the issuer switch, the switch retrieves the offset value from the CMS system and passes it to the HSM for the PIN validation. This is how a customer select PIN works. Some additional references for further reading. The PCI PIN security requirements document is a very good document to look at how the PIN gets or PIN should be encrypted at the terminal. In this video, I have mentioned HSM has the keys. However, in general, HSM and the KMS systems can be separate. In this video, I have not covered the asymmetric key based encryption method for the PIN value, where the customer select PIN can be selected from the web portal or a mobile application, etc. These are some of the links which have some useful calculators for PIN offset and PIN block. Thank you for watching the video. Do like the video if you learned something new from it. I would love to see your comments as well. Thank you.